Let's talk about the CapCut project setting. When you import a video into your timeline, CapCut automatically chooses the aspect ratio of your project based on the footage you imported into your timeline. For instance, this video is a 16:9 aspect ratio, perfect for long form videos on YouTube. If you're creating a video for TikTok or YouTube Shorts, you might want to change from this aspect ratio. Click on the 16:9 right here. Then you can change to whatever aspect ratio you want. Here you can change from the 16:9 to 9:16. Afterwards, you can select the footage and zoom in to the appropriate scale. Another way to adjust your aspect ratio and resolution to get some advanced tools is to click on this modify right here. Here you can name your project. Let me call it Running Man. Now I have a name for my project. As for the project's location, it is saved into your CapCut installation folder. After changing the name of the project, I can as well change the aspect ratio right here. The resolution, you can leave it at adapted if you want to retain the quality of your footage. If you are sure about how to alter your resolution, here you can change to whatever resolution you want. This is a HD resolution, 1920x1080p. You can choose to edit in HD resolution, even if you have a 4K video in your timeline, by using this custom option right here. But I just leave it at adapted to retain the quality of the footage in my timeline. You can as well change the frame rate of your projects. If you understand frame rates in cameras and you filmed your video in a particular frame rate, you can change from this 30 FPS, which is the default for CapCut, into whatever frame rate you filmed your video. For this color space, you want to leave it at Rec 709, which is the standard, except you are sure you filmed your video in HDR or PQ, just leave it at this Rec 709. Then for the performance right here, if you want to get a smooth playback, especially if you're running on a slow computer, just move over to this performance and turn on proxy. This will help you edit smoothly. So with the proxies, you can step down your resolution in the timeline to something that will allow your videos to play back smoothly. You can change to 540 to get an even smoother playback if your computer is really slow. After changing all of the settings, just click on the save button. Now we have a new look for our project. Let me know if you have any questions. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up and subscribe. I'll see you next time.